Hi, this is Govardhan, working as Associate Professor in G. Polarity Engineering College. So let us discuss about, so what are all the control structures that are available in C programming language. The control structures are of two types. So conditional control structures and unconditional control structures. And in the conditional control structures, so first the compiler will check the truth value of the condition. So if the condition is evaluated as true, then some set of instructions will be executed. Otherwise, another set of instructions will be executed. And in unconditional control structures, so without checking any condition, so the compiler will execute some set of instructions. So a statement in C programming language. So some instruction to do something is also called as a statement, and it specifies order of execution and evaluation. In C programming language, a statement may be any of the following. So labeled statement, expression statement, compound statement, selection statement, iteration statement, and jump statement. So now we will see. So what are the conditional control statements in C programming language? And compound statement. So what is a compound statement? So a sequence of statements surrounded by flower braces. So if any number of statements so that are enclosed within flower braces is called as a compound statement in C. So the reason is so that we can group together statements in loops, if-else statements, and functions, etc. So the compound statements may be nested. So that means, so we can place one compound statement so within another compound statement. So the first one is if-else statement. So first we will see the syntax of if-else statement. So if expression and set of statements, else set of statements. The else clause is optional. So if this else part is there, that is called as if else statement. If this else block is not there, then that is called as simple if statement. So we will see how it works. So if the expression value is true, then only compiler will execute the set of statements one. Else, otherwise, that means the expression value is evaluated to false, then the compiler will select second set of statements and it will execute second set of statements. And this is one example of if else. So if j greater than limit, so if this condition is true, then it returns the value of j. Else, otherwise, the j value will be incremented by step value. So these are the some of the examples of if-else statements. And concatenated if-else statements. So the if-else statement will be concatenated two or more number of statements. So if the expression is true, then it will select statement 1. Else, otherwise, if the expression 2, then statements 2. If expression 3 is true, statements 3. So likewise, so we can write any number of else if blocks, and finally if all the expression values are evaluated to false, that is expression 1, 2, 3 and 4 are false, then the statement 5 is the default block, so that will be executed finally. So last else is always attached to last if. If it should be attached to any other if, use flower braces to control the flow of execution. And one more thing is, so switch statement. So if there are many number of alternatives to select, then go for switch statement. So if one option is there, then go for simple if statement. If two options are there, so based on the condition value, so we can select either of the two. So if the options are many, then we need to go for switch statement. So this is the syntax and example of switch statement. So switch some value or expression, and case 0, case 1, case 2, case 3, and finally some default case. So each and every case is terminated by the break statement. So whenever the compiler executes the break statement, so directly the control will come out of the complete switch statement. So case values must be constants. So here the case values must be numeric constants or character constants. And break statement needed jump over subsequent cases. So if thus month value will be matched with case 0, 1, 2 and 3 are these case labels. If the month value is matched with any one of the case, so the statements which are associated with that particular case will be executed, and finally with the break statement the control will be come out of this switch statement. So default case is optional. So there are iterative statements. If a set of statements are need to be executed number of times, so depending on the situation or based on the problem statement, so if we need to execute some set of instructions repetitively, so the in that case, so while, for and do while loops will be used. So this is the syntax of while loop. So while, expression and statement. So the while, until the expression value is true, then the statements will be executed repetitively or many number of times. So until the expression value become false. So the statement will be, sometimes it is a compound statement or it is a set of instructions. So this is the example program for while loop. So note initialization of sum and count. So initially sum equals to 0 and count equals to 0. And so double sum by count, so that is calculation of average. And the double is, that is called typecasting. So that is integer by integer always gives integer value. That integer value is typecasted to double value, and we are printing the double value. And do while. So in the do while is called as exit controlled loop. So in while statement or while control structure, that is called as entry controlled loop. So at the time of entry of the loop, the condition will be evaluated, and in do while statement, the expression will be evaluated at the end. So in do while loop, the statements will be executed at least once, and for the first time the statement will be executed, and then it will check the expression value. If the expression value is false, then it will come out of the loop. And breaking out of a loop, by using a break statement we can come out of the loop, and by using the continue statement, so we can repeat the loop for the next time by skipping the next instructions. So for loop, so in while loop and do while loop, so there are three separate statements of initialization of the loop control variable, and that loop control variable must be used in the condition or expression in the while or do while statement, and within the body of the loop, so we need to increase or decrease or modify the loop control variable. But in for loop, so it is a very flexible control structure where the single for loop contains so three, so that is initialization, condition verification and modification. So all these are included in the single line. So if this expression one is the, so first one, that is initialization of the loop control variable, and expression 2 is the condition, and expression 3 is the modification statement. So 0 is false, non-zero is true. So the for loop and while loops, so these are the examples and syntaxes. So the most common kind of for loop, so for I equals to 0, I less than limit, I plus plus, so this for loop will execute the set of instructions for many number of times until this condition I less than limit become false. So this is the for loop example programs for the for loop and nested for loop. So nested for loop is nothing but placing one for loop within another for loop. So that is called as nested for loop. So in the case of C99, so the for loop, in the for loop, the initialization statement, so at the time of initialization we can declare the variable int I, so this is the declarative statement, and at the same time we are initializing some value, so this is valid in C99. So nested on loops, nodes on loops type. So some simple calculation of mean and standard deviation program, so by using any one of the repetitive statements, while, do while and control statements. So thank you very much.